Hey guys, welcome to my channel LearnTech. This is Sandeep Kohl. Hope you guys are doing good. So today's video, we will talk on filter phasing. So you know, in BMC, especially in filters, we have a concept called filter phasing. So this is a default feature in BMC Remedy. So today we will understand what exactly is filter phasing, and also we will see how this filters execute in different phases. So to understand it better, let's first of all go through the official documentation for BMC for phasing. In filters, if you write a filter, normal filter, so it always executes in three phases. So basically it has three phases in which the actions in the filter are divided. So you can see in the first phase we have these number of actions. Similarly, in the second phase we have these two actions, push field and direct SQL, and we have this phase three which will execute these three actions. Now I will explain you why it is basically in three phases and why these actions are executed in three. So you consider this from a business case scenario. For example, you have a form. There are multiple filters written on the form. So we will have a form where we have multiple filters executing multiple operations in a form. So what happens as filters are server objects and they execute on server side and perform database operations. So what we have done, that we have phased all actions which are basically where there is no database update required, database query or modification required. So they have been grouped together in phase one. So for example, I have 10 filters in a form. So all 10 filters phase one action will be executed first. Suppose I have two filters where I have this call guide and exit guide, then I have one filter with set field action, and plus additionally the phase two actions also. So it will club all the actions together and then will create a phase one for that particular operation. Then it will execute the phase two operations. So here phase one operations, they are mostly related to the processing of the data or the massaging of the data. So you can see the actions here like set field, message, service, log to file. These are all related to the operations which are in the workflow where you define different type of work to be done by that particular filter. Now the second phase comes the database part, where you do some modifications in the database. So you push something into the database, you modify something in the database, you create something in the database. So that is this phase two, where you have push field and you have direct SQL. Now the phase three is basically decided to notify. That means after, initially I did my all processing initially with phase one actions, then I modified the database in phase two using the push field and direct SQL, then I used phase three to notify somebody. I can also run a process to do some other operation to notify somebody or to do something else. And then DSO is for distributed server object. This is to cascade the data or to traverse the data to the other AR server objects. So the main purpose of doing this phasing or filter phasing is to divide the operations to improve the performance of the system. So I'll explain you. For example, if I will not do the filter phasing, what will happen? So if I will not do the filter phasing, suppose I have 10 filters in which I have all these operations, push field, direct SQL, notify, run process, and these phase one actions. So then in that case, what will happen? It will take one filter, it will execute phase one, it will execute the condition, which is like whatever is there, like direct SQL or push field, then we have set field, and then we have this actions, notify, run process. So it will do multiple transactions on the database depending upon the different type of operations in the filter. For example, push field, direct SQL in one filter, then again push field, direct SQL in another filter. So similarly, what will happen, it will decrease the performance of the system. Now to cater this, BMC has divided these this filters in three different phases. I will show you how exactly this works in real scenario. and what is the my use. So for example, let me go here in the this directory. So here, you know, the filter phasing, I have written a filter here, normal filter, and I have written two conditions, which is push field and set field. So you can see the push field is initially, and then we have set field. So if we go the normal scenario, it should execute the push field first, and then it should execute the set field. So because we have not overridden the filter, it is currently not phased. So then once we do this operation, afterwards I will show you how to phase out this filter, or how to do the filter phasing for this. Now let me go back to this. Okay, let me go and clean this log. So let me do some operation. Okay, so you can see this is the log which is generated. Let me copy this log and let me go here. Okay, so let me go to the top. So you can see here. So now this filter which we have written, this one. Sorry. So okay, our filter is sorry, this one. So now you can see the push field action is initially started. So this is the student marks table where we are pushing the data using the push field action. So what it will do, it will not do this operation now. It will show us that this is the action here. So this is the phase two operation. So you can say this particular push field is the phase two operation, and it will initially try to execute the phase one operation, which is set field. So you can see here it can do the set field action. I think somewhere here it has already done the set field action. Yeah, so it will do this set field action on student table, and then it will execute the push field. So here you see, then filter level checking student filter phase and perform. So now it is deferred to phase two. So that means it is not a phase one action, so it will not be performed now. It will go to the next stage. So we can see here it has done all the operations. Once it is done, then afterwards, once it will do the set field. So this is, you can see here, this this push field is deferred to phase two, so it has not performed this operation. And now it will first do the set field action, and then it will do the push field action, which is here itself. It is basically doing it. It is performing this operation here in this after the set field action. But in actual scenario, you will see here the operation push field is first, and then we have second field. But this filter is not phased out. It is performing it as per the phases. Because set field is part of phase one operation, so it will perform this one, and then it will go to the second phase two operation, which is push field. Now we will override this. Okay, let me go and search this. Student. So what we have to do, just I will rename. Now to put a filter in filter phasing, there are two common components which we have to put, which is this one. We call it toe and exclamation mark. I'll copy it here. I will copy it here. It is here in this. So it is this. So you can see if I will phase this out here, it will be like this. Now if I put this toe and exclamation mark, it will phase out this operation, and the filter operations will be you know, they will be processed as per the operation. So let me open it again. Now we have push field first and we have set field. So let's now try it. Let me clear the log and let me try to perform this operation.
So let me copy this log. Then we will see this filter. Okay, let me go to that filter.
Yeah, so the concept of filter phasing is basically put the filters in the operations of filters in different phase. And here I have just copied the log. Here I have just disabled some of the filters to showcase you this. So you can see here this push field action of this particular filter is being executed first. So because is this filter push field action is, yeah, let me go back to the filter. So the push field action is the first action, then the set field, and then I have added this message here. So now because the operations are very small, so it is very difficult to identify it here in the on my form to all the operations in a sequence. But in actual scenario it works this way. If you override it by adding this particular toe and this exclamation mark at the end of the filter, then the operations will execute as per the order. It will do whatever is written first, then second, then third. But if you are not added this, then it will execute it as per the phases which I have explained you earlier, and then it will execute whatever operations you add in respective of its manner. It will execute it in phases. Phase one will be executed first, then phase two, and then phase three. I think this is it for filter phasing. You can explore it more. You can try to write filters with phase, then without phase, and you will see the difference, what is basically happening in actual scenario. Unless and until you practice it like on your system, by writing the code, by writing the workflow, you will not understand it properly. And the usage of filter phasing will also come in picture when you will basically do the practical example of executing the code, verifying it, and then you will see why it is there and what is the use of this phasing. This is it from my side. So please subscribe to my channel. If you have liked the video, please like my video. Thank you.